Today, science fiction is a huge genre of film, with titles grossing the most money worldwide and with franchises growing the most dedicated fan bases of all time. However, science fiction wasn't always like this. In fact, science fiction is still a relatively new genre of film. Hello, my name is Julianna Feit, and today I'll be talking to you about the uncharted territory of science fiction and film. One of the first science fiction franchises that I was ever introduced to was Star Wars, a series of movies that changed film, culture, and science fiction forever. This past Thanksgiving, my family and I sat down to watch the first Star Wars movie, Star Wars Episode IV, A New Hope. We all loved it and found something unique about the movie that we enjoyed the most. For example, my grandparents were in awe of the technology. My parents reminisced about the joy they felt when they first saw the movie in theaters. And my siblings and I found the plot and setting interesting and funny. In this one instance, Star Wars bound us all together and showed me how science fiction can cross boundaries. Using his unique ability to transcend the generation gap, George Lucas, the writer and director of many of the Star Wars movies, was able to play the masses. However, he also felt like he needed more time to tell the story that was Star Wars. Studios recognized this, and therefore, Lucas was given the opportunity to make a sequel. In fact, he made a lot of sequels. He also made some prequels. Due to this success, it was strange. It changed the industry. Back then, movies didn't make sequels. They won Oscars. There was never a Gone with the Wind 2 or a Return to Casablanca. But now, many movies are made solely because studios think they might get a successful sequel out of it. One of the first reasons that Star Wars blew up on such a global scale was because of its groundbreaking and innovative technology. Keep in mind, this movie was made just 1 year after CGI, computer-generated imagery, was invented, meaning that the sophisticated technology that we have for movies today was definitely not around. But despite the incredible graphics, Star Wars' storyline was also new and exciting. First of all, it was set a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. How cool is that? Not to mention the fact that everything was full of creatures, spaces, and planets that we, the audience, had never seen before. It was amazing. Another thing that made Star Wars a different kind of movie was its sound. Weird, I know, but sound was actually crucial. Ben Burtt, the film industry's first ever sound designer, was able to make Star Wars sound original, clean, sharp, and strong. George Lucas also helped the process by trading out stereophonic sound, used since the 1950s, for THX speakers and the Dolby system, used today. But despite the advancements that Star Wars made for filmmaking itself, it also affected the commercial aspect of movies. Merchandising. How many of you have a t-shirt, sweatshirt, or toy dedicated to your favorite TV show, book, or movie? I know I do. This is largely thanks to Star Wars. I'm sure anyone who was around at the time can attest to the fact that when Star Wars met its young prime, every kid had to have that action figure, those pajamas, that bed sheet that matched their favorite character from Star Wars, much like today. Also, video games. Space Invaders, Pong, Pac-Man, they might seem crude today, but back then they were exciting pieces of new technology. Science fiction was a huge part in this. Science fiction and movies like Star Wars pushed forward the people who would eventually invent video games, while also targeting the audience that would want to play them. Also, pioneering companies. George Lucas, after he was making his millions off his movies, he wanted to put it towards something else. After owning the rights to his movies and leasing them to 20th Century Fox for a fee, George Lucas founded ILM, Industrial Light and Magic Company. This company was designed specifically for special effects, and it did great. It was like magic. But Lucas wasn't done there. He also founded a small company designed specifically to make composite effect shots and to push the industry forward in that way. He later sold this company to Steve Jobs, and as I'm sure many of you know, this company, now known as Pixar, is full of some of the most intelligent people who have been working at animation, and had been great at it. But now that I'm done raving about Star Wars and its great advancements, where is science fiction going? In Back to the Future, a very popular science fiction movie premiering in 1985, the future, or 2015, was shown to be incredible with flying cars, self-timed shoes, and hoverboards. It was amazing. And although none of this was ever actually commercially achieved by 2015, it was a great example of how optimistic science fiction was at that time. Today, movies like Divergent and Hunger Games show how science fiction has taken a darker twist, more towards dystopian, and although we don't know how the plots of the future will develop, we do know that technology will be right there with it. In Avatar, one of the most successful science fiction movies of all time, Zoe Saldana, a human, acted as Neytiri, a creature of Pandora, using the technology of motion capture. In fact, much of the movie relied on CGI and motion capture technology. And if box office results are any indication, it paid off. Also, in Rogue One, a Star Wars story, another Star Wars movie I know, the filmmakers designed and used an air cannon that was specifically designed to mimic explosions. This allowed actors and motion and camera operators to get closer to the action, making everything more realistic for the actors and the audience. Speaking of realism in science fiction, it's difficult to attain. Personally, I love science fiction. It's one of my favorite genres of anything. But I love it when it's done well. The great science fiction writers are able to transport you to a different place, a different time. It's so beautiful when done right. And for so long, this has been an advantageous quality for movies to possess. If your movie and your quality of cinema is so fantastic and amazing that it completely immerses the audience in whatever story you're trying to tell, then I definitely would like to see it. The future holds things we've never seen before, and the future of science fiction holds content in uncharted territory. And I don't know about you, but I, for one, am excited to see what the great minds of sci-fi have in store for us. Thank you.